It's Emma from Uncrafty ASMR, and today I thought we'd have a little look through one of my recent purchases, finds, hauls, whatever you'd like to call, of vintage, authenticated vintage material. Now, there is all sorts of things in here. You can probably see there's bits of newspaper already. There's pictures, there's letters, there's all sorts of things. I haven't looked through all of it. I mean, I just picked it up, saw what it was, letters, and put it together in a bundle and purchased it. Now, there's lots of little things in the letters and stuff like that as well. And some of this is going on my Etsy. So be aware of that. I'm not sure what yet because I haven't really looked at it, but some of it will go on my Etsy. So first thing is this really old piece of paper, newspaper. It's like it's from some sort of journal. And it's got a lovely picture on the other side. It's folded up though. That would make a lovely page in a journal. That's nice. And I've got some random letters that are not in an envelope. So this one is hard to read, and it's dated 1975. Detail on the notepaper here, embossed detail. It's really pretty. It's got "Please answer me" at the bottom. It's really cute. I love the paper. It's very pretty. I love the envelope though, look, the detail inside the envelope. It's really pretty. Oh, this is a letter. See the date on it. The date on that. So it says inside, sometimes I did it. On paper. Oh. Typed paper. Headed typed paper. This is 1956. So that's a really nice bit of shiny wallpaper there. A nice brown envelope with writing on and stamps. This is a ration book. Danish ration book. Oh wow, and it hasn't been used much. Look at that, that's nice to have. What was it dated? '47. The last date in here. That's nice to have. The date on the front is 1930. A it says 1947 at the top there. That's fun. And there's some photographs in here as well. With advertisement on the back. Copenhagen. Slight water damage on that one, but it doesn't matter too much. But they're nice. And Mr. and Mrs. Another letter with not in the way. It's a handwritten letter. No date on it. But lovely handwritten letter. I like to use these in my journaling as sort of like a background. Depending on what the size is, but I like you can use them as pages and write over them or ephemera over them, or you can use them as a background on the page. And because they're blank to the side as well. So they're nice. And it's old paper again, it's lovely. Lovely. I love the feel of old paper. A letter there. Cute little letter. Cute little envelope. Letter in. Nice square pages. This is 97, or it could be 47 or 49 actually. It's a nice letter. 5 pages of nice squared paper. It looks like it's written in pencil though. That's nice. And then you got a lovely little envelope as well. This is a receipt, a reservation for something. Ticket 1956. Some more letters, love letters. Something else in here. There's 2 things in here. This is written in pen. I don't know what date this is. This is a nice book. I like writing, a lovely writing. Double-sided. This is old writing paper. You can feel the quality. This is quite nice. It's in pencil. But it's lovely to have in the journal, that. I love a journal. It's lovely paper. You've got your own space to write if you want to. Oh, bits of tickets and things and a little envelope. One in hiding. That looks like it's 1948, that one. It's a train ticket or a bus ticket. These are like hard cardboard bus tickets. And receipts and a few more bus tickets. Another bus ticket. This one's a bit, it looks like a train ticket. Tram tickets, basically, and more bus tickets with a receipt in them from Copenhagen. parcel of stamps I made up. These are the photographs. You may have seen some of these in the pictures on Instagram. This is looks like the town hall in Copenhagen, or the shopping centre in Copenhagen. This is a random picture, and it says, looks like it's half a postcard. This one is Denmark. It's a postcard. Well, this is a cooking recipe. And this shouldn't be in here. It's from the 80s Encyclopedia. So I've put these pictures back in this little envelope that I've created to keep them safe, with a little packet of stamps. I'll go back and look at these. I've got lots of these letters, which I'm not going to look at them. I'm just going to make sure if there's anything else inside them other than the letters. No. This feels like a thick one. But no, that's not. There's other things in here as well. The letters. Written in pencil again though. Not the best. Lots of... Looks like there's some children writing as well. That's nice. That's normal letter. Just a quality of paper. 1948. And this is... Looks like children writing almost. This is a 1948. That's nice. Let's keep them together. Some this is where it was too, and then the label underneath is like where it's from. Oh, this item, a lot of the items here are the 1940s. The little ones. I love the little ones because they're so sweet to put in journals. Maybe 49. Written, handwritten paper, double-sided, good quality paper, cute little envelope, and this one was from Norway, that one's from Italy here, yeah, one's from Italy, fold it up, hotel paper. That really helps protect the letter and the paper, so that's really nice. And these, the writing on these, this paper, and it's good quality, it's watermarked paper again. There's actually a watermark in it, but it's good quality writing paper. And it's it's a nice way of spreading it out because you can put that in your journal, and then you have, there's a whole page there that you can use for ephemera and little bits and pieces on it and some stamps, and then you have the next page is blank, so you can do your own writing there, and then you have another page that you can decorate and so forth, which I find in my journaling is really useful and a nice touch. And then you have a nice little envelope to go with it as well. That's at least two good pieces there. Oh, this one's got a photograph in. It's not going to come out. Oh yeah, there's a photograph in there. Looks like Tivoli in Copenhagen. It's a photograph postcard from the Netherlands, with a Netherlands stamp on it. It's 1957. And make sure I'm not pulling the wrong part. The letter that doesn't want to come out. Again, that's another. Probably from the same person with a pretty typing on. So quite a few of these letters with envelopes, without envelopes unfortunately. 1957. That's good quality paper though still. Oh, these are postal. I looked at these. These are postal labels or labels for post and bills and things like invoice. Slips. That's quite nice to have to put, and they're blank, so they're not used. But the paper quality is very thin, but it's a nice nice quality still. Nice to have the different types and framra. I can't even say that today. They have been folded, but I wasn't in the envelope, but I wasn't very keen on doing that again. This is a picture. It looks like somebody's split this up to copy it, to paint it with the squares. But it's a very nice picture as it is. I think it's in pencil. And a bit of old paper at the back there. A few of these pictures from cards. These are postcards, Christmas postcards. I like to collect these. They're very nice. I love the scenes. This is a bill. You've probably seen that in pictures. And a bit of this is actually something I picked up for free. It's just an old book, but it's a games. A card games book. I don't know what year it is, but I just liked it. I thought it was fun. It's definitely old paper. Some more from Boo. Some all sorts. I haven't seen these before. Cards. Bus cards and train cards. Isn't that cute? And a little letter on some little bits of paper. Unfortunately, it's written in pencil, so it's very vague. Probably can't see it, but the date is 29th of the 10th, 57 on it. Cute little bundle of papers there. And some cards. Okay, there's one in here as well, there's extra. It's a bus card though. A train ticket, this one is another old letter. Gosh, that is really, oh no, I thought it really faded, but it hadn't. It's just, I was reading in the reverse. 1948, this one. Lovely bit of paper there, written paper. Oh, this is a picture that I quite liked. Very old and dusty. I think it's actually, yeah, it's actually a card. Some sort of card. It's quite nice. This is, I looked at this, I think it's like some sort of song or poem. It's in German, so my German is rubbish. It's 1958, and yes, there's a bit of German poetry, or I think it might even be a song. This is a Christmas card from the 70s. And then we've got my a few postcards that I picked up. Appointment card. Christmas cards. That one we have already. But with stamps. I'm very fun. I like Christmas cards. I like postcards. I think they're lovely. Black one. Very pretty. And with a cross stitch Christmas card there. A few more photographs. Postcard photograph. It's got 17 on it or 18 on it, so I'm not sure when that was. A few more Christmassy postcards. Taking the stamps off there, it's a bit of a shame. But they're good for sticking in journals or covering the back and making your own. This is a sad Easter card that has broken, unfortunately. It's still there, but it is a bit tatty. That's 1954, that one. A few more receipts and an advert, which is quite sweet, for a haberdashery. That's a bill. Not sure what date it is on there. That's quite nice. I like that. It's nice. Some letters that have come away from their envelopes. 1944, that one. That's earlier. This one has lovely writing again. No date on it. Definitely 40s though. That one, I'll see if I know what that one is, so we'll save that one for last. And some little photos. Girl Scouts or Cubs. Another photo here. Dirty photo, but photo still. I like this one because I love the card back. They're called day cards, something like that. This is a photograph, a wedding photograph, which is quite nice. And this is the card that housed it. But you could put those discs separately. This is another bit of, this is a letter, but this is a printed letter. Nice paper. With a little picture, a scene, and this is a birthday card. It's got a letter with it as well. I've seen this one. This is one other one I picked up. I actually thought it was a Christmas card to start with, but it's actually a birthday card. 1915. No, that's right. So another headed paper. With a lovely letter, but unfortunately it's in pencil in the back. And then there's this lovely card. See if I can open it to show you. Look at that. It's a lovely pop-up card. I reckon it's about 52, something like that, the age of it. And this, there's nothing written on in the inside at all, which is quite nice for journaling wise. So it doesn't really matter. But there is written on the, oh, it's 56. It's written on the back, and it says 1956. So if this was, for example, this was your journal, right? You could put this on the page like so, and have it so it opens out, right? Like so, and glue that down so you won't see that. I think that's a lovely piece to have in a journal. And if you wanted to, you have the pages underneath to write in it if you want to do that as well. But I think it's a lovely piece to have. 1956, that one. Original envelope, as far as I'm aware. Certainly fits nicely, matches up. So here, this is my little stash of bits and pieces that I bought recently. Some of these pieces I have seen, I had a look through, and some of them I have not. I have a few cards and letters that I haven't looked through even now. But I will. If there's anything you see that you would like to have for your journaling, then let me know, and I'm sure we can make arrangements or give you a price. Those as well. Put these in here as well. This is a little envelope that I made, or half an envelope, and these are just carries the little photographs that I also purchased that day. And this is just a little